guys, what is going down? And welcome to episode 2 of the Shred series.
Grab that gimbal, bro.
Hey guys.
What's going on, guys? Welcome to the vlog today. It's the 17th of September.
Today is shoulders day. It's time to get pumped. Matt, are you pumped?
I'm pumped.
Matt's pumped.
Do you have any pumps?
I'm pumped.
So guys, we're here at Empire Fitness. I don't know how long ago they've renovated it, but last time I was here, it was like really old, and now it's just crazy. I was talking to Ari, the owner. He said they spent like 1.5 mil on renovations. It's a little bit of a drive for me, so I won't be signing up here, but I'm gonna come here, train twice a week, and do posing practice straight after. I'm really gonna try and refine my posing over the next 8 weeks. It's gonna be like one of the most important things. I know I can get in shape. I know I've got aesthetics and all that. But if I don't have a good routine and I get all stiff up on stage, you know, that won't be good. I need to make a good routine second nature. So, Matt, we're going to come up with a posing routine today, bro.
You're going to kill it.
Oh, yeah. And I'm having BCAAs, guys. I didn't take supplements for probably like 3 years, maybe just a protein powder. Even if that, sometimes I wouldn't. But since these last few months, Matt, was it you? He's like, yeah, get a pre-workout. And then I ended up just getting aminos. And I was like, had these aminos in my system. And I'm like, oh my God, I missed this so much. Anyway, so we're here gonna train some shoulders today. It's gonna be a sick session. I've been pumped all day for this. We've had the stuff happen with little Halo. It's been a stressful couple of days, but it's time to just have a sick shoulder session. Absolute monster session, all done and dusted. Feeling amazing. Actually, I'm kind of exhausted, but the pump was good, man. Good tricep pump, good shoulder pump. Officially 8 weeks out today. So it's time to do a physique check, run through some posing. Today I begin my first posing session. I haven't done like an actual routine run through. I don't really know exactly what I'm doing. I'm gonna do a lot of research over the next few days. Just find out kind of like what the routine is on stage by looking at past shows, but it's time to see how this physique is shaping up. Don't go tell me he's the one. Definitely tightened up over the last, definitely 4 days I've noticed. I'm so used to doing all these bodybuilding poses, that's what I feel comfortable in. It's going to be a real challenge with the WBFF because it's more so artistic posing. I really need to start getting comfortable in those kind of like...
Looking good,
thanks, mate. Yeah. Where I'm at, I know I can get stage ready. I've been looking at a few other competitors just so that I've been seeing popping up around like on Instagram and shit because I know people. Most people in terms of the conditioning, they seem to be a lot ahead of me, but I was talking to Matt before, I'm just not going to let it psych me out because I decided 9.5 weeks out to do the show. It's just believing in myself. I've done it before. Blinders need to be on. It's up to me over these next 8 weeks to just bring it the fuck out. So what do you reckon, Matt?
Beep, beep, wide load coming in. Number 98, Friesma. Show off those quads.
I think it's gonna have to be to start with. It'll be like something like that. Like I know I'm just way off the shredded, but I know I'll come in and the shape, everything's there. These last 6 months have paid off, man. I've just been going so hard off YouTube, just doing it for myself again and feel like so good. In exactly 1 week when we're doing the next posing routine, I'm gonna have everything down packed. This is literally, you guys have seen it, the most raw footage of me just being in here, not even thinking about a posing routine. So it'd be cool to see me lock it down, I guess, over the next
develop your routine.
Guys, I need to take the camera off Matt here. We need to give him the biggest fucking shout out because he is the man behind the series. I'm the man in front of the series. He's the man behind the series.
go. You're behind the series.
It's been a bit of a joint effort, but anything like epic, is this guy right here. So I'm gonna link his channel below. Go show him some love. Guys, can we get him to 700 subscribers? Can we do that? Freeze fam, can we get Matt to 700 subscribers right now?
If we do it, I will pet a wild koala.
That would have been a sick gym here today.
Yeah, it's gonna be sick. I guess they already saw it or they didn't see it.
They've seen it. Guys, was it
speaks,
sick?
Speaks for
comment
itself.
Below, comment below.
This is the beast behind the scenes right
here. Yeah, this is what
the Zion Crane 2 with the Canon 200D.
I was expecting you to say you'd compete if you were gonna hit 700.
Yeah, I thought I was gonna like say I was gonna compete.
Like, I'll compete too.
I will compete in 2019 in Canada.
Guys, it's actually crazy getting these aesthetics back. Like, it's been so long since I've, you know, I did that little series before Christmas. I probably got a little bit leaner than this, man. And this is me like 8 weeks out from a comp, so I'm legit, I have to get to like 5% body fat, so.
Guys, I actually just wanted to stop the video and address, I've been seeing a few comments around, you know, like my Instagram, YouTube and all that kind of stuff. People are saying, are you back on gear? Are you thinking about running gear? Are you going to be running gear for this comp leading up to it? Why are you competing in a non-tested federation? You know, this is stuff that's, it's kind of annoying to address, but I get it. Like, I know in the past on my channel, I've talked about stuff like this and I've opened up for discussion, I guess, but I just really want to sit down and just address shit now because it's kind of annoying. Like, I don't want to have to reply to these comments. A lot of people, it's like people who, you know, doing steroids and going to the gym is all their life is, and they don't have much followers online, so they like to just be like, oh, I like find someone who's doing shit and be like, yeah, he's gonna run this gear and shit. Other people maybe who don't understand, or they think, oh, he's done it before, like why wouldn't he just do it again? But I just want to actually just sit here and have like a real chat with everyone, because it's something that is like, probably a lot of people wouldn't talk about it, but I'm more than happy to talk about it because I have in the past. So I just want to say, no, I'm not on gear. No, I haven't even thought once about doing gear for the show. I haven't touched gear since October 2015, guys. That's pretty much 3 years ago, which is, it's pretty crazy to think that. And if you watch my physique timeline video, you'll see a full, honest and open recap of my whole life, my whole physique, the points where I've thought about doing it, the points where I've done it, what I've done, like all that shit. I'll link the video below, but if you watch that video as well, you'll see how good I can look naturally. And I feel like my physique now, I feel like I'm not as big as I was back then, but I feel like my shape is a lot better. So I'm just really excited for, you know, in 8 weeks time to see what I can do, because I'm just feeling like on the path. I'm feeling so elevated. I'm glad that for the last couple of weeks, my body has shaped up well, and it's kind of removed any even doubt of like, oh shit, do I need to take something? Halo, no, do not. Standing up, cute fuck. Yeah, so I just wanted to address that. Also, why am I competing in a non-tested federation? Guys, the WBFF seems to be not only like the least political out of the feds, but the fact that they just put on such a good show. The caliber of athletes is a lot higher. I want to be competing against the best. And from what I've seen, you know, regardless of whether people are taking gear or not, I'm here to judge no one. If they are, cool. I'm not going to, and I'm going to be competitive against every motherfucker stepping on that stage. I want to win this competition. If I don't, it's not the main goal. Yeah, I do want it. If it happens, it'd be awesome. I'd love to go pro. I would go compete overseas and do all that. You guys are probably like, whoa, shit, this guy's really into his fitness again. Like, it's crazy. I'm just loving this again. It feels right. But yeah, regardless of whether I place or win or anything, I'm just excited to get back up on the stage in almost 6 years, guys. Can you believe that? 6 years. It's gonna be absolutely insane. So regardless of the result, these next 8 weeks, I'm going hard. No gear, nothing. I haven't touched this stuff in 3 years. And if you watch the Steroids Ruin My Life video, which I posted maybe a couple of years ago, I think it's pretty clear, like, I'm never fucking doing gear again because I don't need to. I don't judge people who do it. I could talk about this forever because I'm passionate about it, but I'm not going to. We're going to get back into the episode, but I hope you guys can just appreciate me sitting down here and actually addressing this stuff and talking about it, because I feel like not many people do. So, yeah, let's get back into the episode.
What do we possibly have? We've got some chicken, which I cooked last night, but I'm feeling like a fizzy drink. So on the shred right now, I'm trying to not have more than one cup of sugar-free drink a day. So as you can probably guess from the series, we're keeping a schedule ahead. So we're about an episode ahead each time we upload. This went live last night, episode one, and the response has been incredible. So just want to say thanks everyone who's checking out on the journey. Shout out to Big Rob, Nabil, Jay, these guys, Matt. Probably the biggest shout out to Matt. But I gotta say, I think the most important comment on here would be this one right here. Because, you know, I don't know if I would have been able to go through with this series if we didn't have Nabil's blessing. So that's a major key. Nabil's like, he's like the gatekeeper of this this community. So guys, any YouTubers out there, you just DM Nabil, make sure you get his blessings before you start uploading, or else there could be consequences. Here's the gatekeeper, like I said. Holy shit. What the fuck? There's a lot of comments. This is absolutely insane. Whoa. You guys are fucking awesome, I gotta say. Jesus, it's still going. What the heck? This is incredible.
I just want to say while we're here, guys, a massive shout out to everyone who's been ordering Gym Steez. The sales have been well down since I've stopped being so active on YouTube. I kind of like accepted that, but the return is here, you know. We've actually had some good drops in between me being not so active, and they've gone all right. But definitely, like, the consistent daily sales have dropped right off. So it is what it is. I'm just glad that I didn't get into YouTube just for, like, just because the sales were dropping off or something, you know what I mean? Like, it's been like that for months, but because there's been so many times, like I've said, guys, where I've wanted to do a big series, and, you know, it's gonna be so great for, like, business and everything like that, but if my heart's not there, like, how can I, you know what I mean? So it's cool with this, because my heart is genuinely, like, the goal is get on stage and, like, make some epic videos for my channel, because my mindset is just elevated now. You guys have no idea kind of what I've been through this year. I haven't, and that's not your fault. I haven't shared it with anyone except for, like, Gemma and some close friends, but some stuff's happened. I might talk about it in the series, but I went through a whole lot of stuff this year, personally, and but no one knows. Maybe I'll talk about that in another vlog. But anyway, we're gonna go and actually catch up with Matt now and make sure these vids are on track. Thumbs up right now if you're enjoying the shit. Let's go.
Out here doing it.
Just at Matt's building over this one here. With these episodes, I'm doing a lot of the editing, which you're seeing, like, these kind of vlogs, me holding the camera stuff. All the gym edits, all the sick cinematic shit is what Matt's doing. So a couple of days a week we're filming together, and then a couple of days we come together and we bring our clips together and upload the vid to YouTube. So that's what we've been doing. Hella exhausted. We're under the pump tonight. But I'm gonna go and hit my session. I'm training back today. Just gonna go to a gym here in Surfers Paradise, which is just down the road. I think I'm going the right way.